first target today, down about 4 to 5 inches in this rich soil, and it's going to be a 1960 penny. So awesome that the first signal and first hole is a coin that's fairly old, and I hope to find some stuff much older than that. So let's keep looking. Okay, it's only been about a minute, got two more targets. Hey, this is kind of weird. It's like a metal fence. It's very odd, not sure what that was from. Maybe some sort of old kid set. An old toy set or something, I have no idea. And then about another 5 inches down, and 1944 wheat penny. So lots of targets here. And it doesn't look like it seems like the ground's original, very rich. So I'm happy. I think we're gonna find some really neat stuff today. Guys, there's no other way to say it. This permission is loaded. I'm really excited to be hunting this place. I got a signal that came in closer to 87, 88. I did dig another wheat penny after the last film, and I pushed it up into the side of my pal here. You can see a silver dime. And it's a silver rosy. Let's try to create some shade here. Looks like 1957. No mint mark. Amazing. It's a beautiful day out here. It's a little windy, but it's like 63 and sunny. Just a beautiful day leading into spring. Let's keep searching. I think we're just beginning. Okay, got a high 70 signal, sometimes rang an 80, and I just got an old key here. It's an old GM key. It's bent up a little bit. But I still love finding old keys. So far on the pennies, I got 3 Wheaties now and 2 Memorials from the 60s. So a lot of activity, at least around the 40s, 50s, and 60s here, it seems. And I have that 57 Rosie to go with it. I've only been hunting about 10 minutes. Let's keep going. So I got a really high signal right here, but it's not all that deep. It kind of rang up like the other silver dime. So just in case it's something good, let's finish it live. I just popped my plug, and I'm reading it real good with the pinpointer. Seems like it's down underneath the plug a little bit. Let's see if we can coax it out on camera. It's down just a tiny bit further. I'll make sure I go around it, so if it's something good, we don't scratch it. Oh, there it is there. That's just a piece of aluminum. Let's keep hunting. By the base of this tree, I think I may have a shallow silver, so I'm going to try and dig it live. Nice mid to high 80 signal. It's a penny. It's an old one though. Not a weedy, but 1965 Memorial. Yep, a lot of stuff from the 50s and 60s here. All right, I had a couple penny signals, one here and there was one here. I dug this one first. I popped this plug about 5 inches deep, and without the pinpointer, I can already see it on the bottom of the hole. And it's a wheat penny. Can't see the year on that one, so I assume the other signal here is going to be a wheat penny as well. Similar signal. I'll let you know. This has turned into a coin spill, so I checked the other signal, dug down, and there's 2 pennies. They're both wheats. You could see it on there. And there's still another signal. It's off to the side here, though. But let's check this hole again with a pinpointer. Okay, so this hole was 2 wheaties stuck together. And I think there's at least one more. Love me a good coin spill. All right, the next hole down, this is where the first coin came from, and then the 2 wheats came from here. This one, it just flicked out of the hole. It's not a wheat though, but go figure, it's a 59 Memorial. So since it was 3 wheats and 59 Memorial, I would assume these coins were dropped in 59 or maybe at the latest 1960 or 61. It's a sweet, nice old coin spill. I rescanned the hole and there was still another signal in with that 59 penny. So I went down about another half inch below it, and it's another wheat penny, 1951. So 4 wheats and 1 memorial out of this little patch. Loving it. I got another nice signal here that seems like it's gonna be either another old penny or maybe a silver dime. I'm not gonna dig it up live because it's pretty windy and I wanna save some time here. So let's get it out, we'll see what it is. Okay, so we just pulled it out of the hole. It's another wheat penny. I lost track. I'm actually already close to 10 already and I've only been here a half hour. So I know there's gonna be some more silver. And now once we clear all these targets out, I'm hoping to find some older stuff too. I am so stoked to find all this modern silver, but today we're on the hunt for some older stuff. And I know it's in here at this location. So let's keep at it. Okay, oldest coin so far. Didn't even think I was gonna get this one. The biggest root of this tree is like right here. I'm not even at the end of it with my finger. It's literally that thick. I thought the signal was underneath it, which would be impossible to get to without half an hour and a saw. But it was in between that root and the one next to it. So I kept digging a little tiny little hole down in there between. And I just popped out this wheat penny. Oldest coin so far. 1939. Right there where a tree looks like it was uprooted, I just got an old rabies vaccination tag, which I'm pretty happy to have because I'm not in my hometown today. So that'll be an interesting one for the collection. I don't want to show too much on it in case it shows the location on it. And I just flipped this plug, had a nice mid-80s signal, and I'll turn the pinpointer on so you can hear it. Can't see it yet, but it's got to be right here. I'm not sure if it's going to be a penny or a silver dime. Looks like a penny. Probably another wheat. That would make it, I think, a dozen now. It's unreal. Yeah, it's a wheat penny. At least I think. I know it's 1950 something. Well, it could be a 59. No, it looks like a 1951 Denver wheat penny. Sweet. Loaded with coins. Love this spot. So that last hole, which is right where my coil's at, off to the side of it, there was actually another penny down there, so that's probably why the signal was higher and I thought it might have been a silver dime. A lot of coin spill. So I got another nice mid-80s tone here. Once again, not sure if this one's going to be a silver dime or a penny, because a lot of these coins are 5 to 6 inches down, which is right about the depth where the tones just start to change a little bit. If they were more shallow, I would know a little bit better. Let's get this turned on. We're right about at it, and it's about at that 5 to 6 inch mark, like most of the old coins here. We'll try to pop it and hopefully hope for a silver this time. But if it's a penny, we'll still be happy. Still down there a little bit. Always try to be careful so we don't scratch her. Okay, we're literally like right on top of it now. There it is. Looks like a penny. Awesome. And it's a weedy. I got something really awesome here. I don't think it's silver because it rang up in the mid-70s. But it's some sort of pendant. Wow. What do we have here? That's really cool. Let me clean it up a second. I think there's a ship on it. This is sweet.
Well, there it is, cleaned up a little bit. I'll have to look at it better later. It has a little bit of gold gilt on it, so I don't really want to rub it too much. But we'll get it cleaned up later. Sweet find.
This is a good sign here. About 2 inches down, I just got a 1961 penny. But the cool thing is it was on top of this gravel. So I think this is where an old driveway used to be. So that's awesome if the old coins are on top of the old driveway. That means there could be some really shallow silver here as well. Okay, right in this hole, I just dug a 1962 penny and got a deep one here. Got it right on the end of the plug, about 6 inches there. And as soon as I flipped some dirt off, I saw the wheat ear staring at me. So it's another wheat. I think I'm at about 15 now. On to the next. So that last hole actually had another wheat in it. I filled it in and pat it back down and re-scanned it, and there was another deep coin in there. I just pulled a zinc penny almost right off the surface there. Got a nice deep 6-inch signal here. And yet again, another wheat penny. This is crazy. Okay, I just flicked something out of this hole shallow here, and I wasn't sure what it was, so I turned the camera on. At a quick glance, it almost looks like a pocket watch gear. And I think that's exactly what it is. Yeah, it looks like the guts to an old pocket watch. Well, that's pretty cool. I'll throw that in the pouch and keep at it. Alright, so I got a blasting signal that was shallow that I skipped the first couple times because I thought it was going to be trash, but as the targets slow down, I'm going back over and digging all those. And I think I have my first relic from the old place here. See, it's got iron on the bottom. I'm not sure what this would have mounted to. It's got a nail through the top too, so this was definitely mounted on something. It kind of looks a little bit like a door ornament or something like that. But it looks really old. Wow. See if I can get it in the shade. There you go. Maybe you can see it a little better now. That's a cool relic right there. I can't wait to clean that up. Very ornate. I'm down under this tree where I started, and I got pretty deep, about 6 inches there. And I knew there had to be a nickel in this place. Just popped one out. It looks pretty old. Hopefully it's a buffalo. Or older. Looks pretty old. Ooh, you know what? Oh, I see stars. I think this is going to be a V-nickel. Oh, sweet. This would have been from the carriage house. Or the main house that was here that burnt down. Oh. Yes. All right. I'll get that cleaned up later and get a date on it. I don't want to rub it too much. The nickels are kind of hard to clean off in the field, and I don't want to rub all the patina off. Awesome. Maybe if we're lucky, it'll be one from the 1800s. Well, actually, it's kind of drying off there. I think the last digit's a 7. It's probably 1907, but it could be an 1897. Awesome. Let's put it in the special pouch and keep searching. Okay, right where this little plug is where I dug the V-nickel. It rang up abnormally high for a V-nickel. It was kind of like 6870, which is much higher than a nickel. And there is something else next to it. But it's real chirpy. I don't know if it's just trash or could be another deep coin. It could be like an old spill. There could be another nickel or like an Indian head in there. It's a really weird tone. But I'm gonna fish around there a little bit and find it, and if it's something good, I'll turn the camera on. The base of this tree has been awesome to me. You can see in this hole there was some shallow clay mixed in, and some, it's like ash too. I'm finding some coal. Let's turn this off. You know, you can tell some of it's pushed around from when they put in a more modern part of the driveway. But just got down there about 5 inches and got a really nice clean 1942 D Weedy. Might get the first sunburn of the year. Man, it's really sunny out here. But I just popped this plug, and I thought this was the signal. It was an 80. It's just like a threaded screw or that busted off of something. And I checked the hole. I still had the signal. It's another penny, and this one is from the 30s. It's 1939, so a nice oldie. One of the oldest pennies so far. But that V-nickel is going to take the cake and the old coins thus far. Maybe we can get even older. Let's keep looking.
Okay, I'm kneeling on the last plug where that 30s wheat and that little screw tip or whatever it is came from. Had a nice tone, just another 6 inches up. Popped a big plug about 6 inches down. You can see there's some glass in the hole. So I'll throw that in my pouch. And you can see the imprint of a coin there, which looks like another penny. I think that's the reverse. You can almost see the detail on the plug. So it should be right here. I don't have the pinpointer out. Oh no, it's not a penny. Oh, this one's a silver. Sweet, let's get in there in the hole. Oh, yay, another silver out of here. It's a Merc, 1943. Awesome. Oh, the targets are in here. I'm just in the same area. I haven't even touched other parts of this property. I just keep going over and over this little patch because it seems like where this is where most of the stuff is and where there hasn't been any fill dirt. Amazing. We'll keep at it. Beautiful looking coin right there. Okay, in case we're onto something good, I may as well show this. I dug a plug right here to dig a big thunky surface signal that was in the low tone range. And I pulled this out. And I'm not sure what it is. It's like thin copper though, which explains why it kind of rang up weird. And right next to it, I had a signal in the 90s that I wasn't sure if it was going to be iron. The signal was cutting out a little bit, but now that I popped the plug, sounds real solid, still in the low 90s. So this could be a silver coin. In the case it is, we're going to finish it live. Still on the plug here. So come on, let's hope for something good. Oh, I saw it. It is silver. Sweet. It's a silver Washington. Let's try to get it in the shade here a little bit. Awesome, man. I'm so glad I was starting to dig all the trash out of here. You can see a D mint mark under the mud there on the back. 1952. Amazing. I'll get it cleaned up later. Oh, so happy. I knelt down right where I just got out that silver quarter and that piece of junk. And got a nice signal here in the 70s, but I knew it was a bigger target. It was just really thunky and only a couple inches down. And it's another pocket knife. I've been doing so well on these over the last year. And this one's wood handled, but it's still there. It's not really deteriorated that much. So that one's gonna look really nice cleaned up. You can see wood handled with like some copper on the ends, and naturally the blades are going to be rusted, but nothing you can do about that. Really happy with that find. Let's keep searching. By the famous tree, I got a low tone down in the mud, faint about 4 inches. And we got it in this little ball here. I'm hoping it's a nickel. It rang right in that range. I see an edge of something there, but it's thinner than a nickel. And, oh, it's a button. Okay, cool. Looks like a four-hole button. So I don't think that's too incredibly old, but it's a button nonetheless and a neat find. Actually, there's some writing on that, so we'll get something off of that. Neat. Whew, I had to bust out the shades and the shade hat today because, man, that sun is just fierce. But hey, we're checking out in behind the carriage house now. All the coins were in the front, which was in between where the current house is built and where the old one used to stand. So it was a good little spot for a lot of stuff from the 40s mostly, but I did get some older stuff. It was all in the front area there. I came back here and I started digging some melted metal and usual scrap. I figured it'd be more of a relic hunt back here. And I got about 6 inches deep in this soft soil.
expecting something a little older, but it's a little reflector. I don't know if that's off of a bike or what. Hopefully we can pop out something pretty old back here. Still in behind here, and I'm gonna stick around here for quite a while. Soil's really soft and stuff seems to be sinking really deep. I got about 8 inches down there. Real easy to dig though, no tree roots back here. And it looks like some kind of brooch. You can see it's got the little clasp there. It's pretty plain looking, nothing to write home about, but it's neat nonetheless, and it's a relic. So yeah, I like that there's some interesting targets coming out back here. I'm sure there's something else good back here. It's just a ton of trash. But this is probably where they toss a lot of their garbage and stuff like that. So I'm gonna sit on the hillside here for a second and tell you a little story. So, this is the last remaining structure from the original house that was here. This was the carriage house. Now, over here, this house was built in the 1930s. It was either 1935 or 1939. The homeowner wasn't, I don't think he was too sure which, but sometime in the very late 1930s. The house that used to be there was called the Gingerbread House. It was built in 1890, and it burned to the ground only about 20 years after it was built. So I'm guessing from around 1910-ish until around the late 1930s when this house was built, this was all just a vacant lot. And obviously this has been here since around the 1890s. So it's a very interesting property. Since they did build this huge house on the middle where the old one used to stood, a lot of the ground around it is disturbed and destroyed and fill dirt and all that. So thankfully, I was able to find that little pocket of stuff on the other side of this carriage house where there was just a lot of old targets, and some of the ground was eroded away, and it was just real easy to dig. It was an awesome little nook there. Now, back where I'm at here, they did something to this. And going up back over the hillside, I'm not sure when they disturbed this ground, but I'm finding like even cans, like modern aluminum cans, down about 8 inches, and doesn't seem like I'm really gonna find much back here. But I'm still gonna work on it a little bit. I still have to work around the edges of the property and the front a little bit more, and hopefully I can find some areas where there's some more old stuff. Alrighty, I just found, I'm literally right up against the back of this place, and I found a button. Doesn't seem too old, probably mid 20th century. It's got some writing on it. Looks like it's probably like an overalls button or something. But yeah, there's still some odd bits scattered around back here, so I'm definitely gonna keep searching. That's pretty neat. We get to have another little chat. I have some more information now. And the homeowner was nice enough to bring me out a bottle of water and an apple. He's an elderly guy that has heart trouble and pretty slow at getting around. My theory about the ground being disturbed here was correct. And the reason why the ground was disturbed back here is because they had a geothermal heating and cooling unit put in. And I used to live a place where there was geothermal. It's pretty neat. You know, it uses the temperature of the air underground to regulate heat and air. And they go pretty deep, some of them, but he said they dug like a 7-foot trench the whole way winding around this property to put the geothermal unit in. But I know some units, man, they go really deep, like 30 to 60 feet or something like that. But anyway, between the house that was built in the 30s and his fence right there, which is where his property ends, there was a house that was World War I era-ish right down there that he had torn down about, I think he said about 15 years ago. And there was another one that was from around World War I also on the other side of the fence that was torn down. And the homeowner in the blue house ended up buying that extra lot after the house was demolished. And he said, I can go around this side too, up around that side of his property. So I'll give it a whirl, just keep making my way around and see what else we can pull up. I figured we'd finish this one live. I'm not sure what it is. Deep high 70s signal. Very deep back here. See what it is. Not sure what that is. Looks familiar though, I've seen something like this before. Not sure if that broke off of something or what. Huh. About 8 inches deep. He's down there quite a ways. Come in the front where the house used to sit that was built around World War I. Got a blasting signal here. It's a toy car, it's a pretty neat one. Look at the top there, it says, "Ride Yourself Wild." That's pretty cool. Should be a date on it. It's not that old. This one, let's see, oh yeah, there we go. I think that's a date right there. I think 1978. I'll have to clean up later. I think that's what it says. Neato. That's a good sign. There may be some more stuff up here. I really like that though. Sweet. I'm working the front part of the carriage house again, and man, it's really drying up. About a half an hour, only dug a few faint targets, but I got one here right against the newer asphalt. Down about 5 inches soft soil, and we got a 1949 nickel. Looks like it's in pretty good condition. I think it's preserved because it was in the rich dark soil that the gravel's mixed in with for the old driveway. Those type of coins always seem to be preserved more. So we squeaked one more out. I'm gonna poke around a little bit longer. Thunky signaled by the base of this tree that I skipped before, pretty shallow. About 3 inches down, and it's another cap gun part. I've been getting a lot of these lately, and that's part of the cylinder there. Pretty cool. Apart from scouting the other parts of the property a little bit, I've probably spent about 3 hours in this little patch, you know, from right in front of here to just down in this way, about halfway to where that tree is, which is the only place where there's really a concentration of old targets. This hole had already been popped before by me. I don't know what else I found in here, but it had a really faint, deep target. I got down here and I kept going through all these big rocks and down and down, and I pulled something out of the hole, and it looks like a silver. Or maybe it's clad. I thought for a minute it was gonna be an old silver, but now that I'm looking at it, it might just be a clad coin. Yeah, I think it's just a dime. Clad dime, yeah. I thought it might just be an old, I thought it might have been an old tarnished silver that looked really black. But no, that's just a clad dime. But I'm still eking out a few targets here, so I'm gonna go a little bit longer. Looks like 1970 something.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to subscribe for more. My next adventure is always just around the corner. Take care, and happy treasure hunting.